Dry Gulch, USA. It's Gospel Bill's Vacation Bible School, featuring the Sheriff of Dry Gulch, Gospel Bill, his sidekick, Nicodemus, that lovable dog, Barkamaeus, Miss Lana, and, of course, Eugene. We'll be playing the All-American Bible Quiz Game, singing and exercising, going to the zoo, and finding out how Jesus can change your life, plus a whole lot more on today's Vacation Bible School. And now, here he is, the sheriff himself, Gospel Bill.
Well, good morning. Hey, it's good to see you, and I want to welcome you to another day of Vacation Bible School. You know that Jesus has the keys of death and hell. Did you know that means that he has the power over death and hell? And when we trust in him, he can deliver us from the power of death. There's a story right here in this book about a man who was dead, but Jesus made him come back to life. I mean, Jesus raised him from the dead because Jesus has power over death. And this book tells us that Jesus is the resurrection. That means that he is the one who raises people from the dead. I am the resurrection and the life. That's what Jesus said. I am the resurrection and the life. And that comes from God's Word. And you know what? God's Word is not an ordinary book. Well, that means that Jesus has the power to make people to live again. So when you trust in Jesus as your Savior, your body may die someday when you get old, but when Jesus returns, your body is going to come back to life again. It's going to be raised up from the dead, and you will live forever. So we're going to be talking about how to live forever today. So you pay real close attention. In fact, you might even be in store for a quiet seat. It might be your day today. Now, teachers, I want you to look all around and pick out somebody to win these quiet seat prizes. Pictures of George Washington. Now, you look all around and find someone who's sitting up real straight and tall. Find someone who's not talking. Find someone who doesn't have his hands on the kid next to him. He's got to have his hands in his lap or down by his side. And find someone who is not getting up out of their seat. If you get up out of your seat without permission, you cannot win a quiet seat. So you got to sit down and be real quiet and still. Now, at the end of the service, the teacher's going to call out the winner. And somebody says, "Oh, Gospel Bill, it won't be me. I never do win a quiet seat." Do you know that's what a boy told me one time? And I told him, I said, "You just act good and you see what happens." And just a couple of times later, he won the quiet seat. So it may be your time to win it today. Now, I want you to bow your heads right now. We're going to close our eyes and we're going to pray. So I want you to listen and I want you to bow your head and close your eyes. Father, thank you. Thank you for bringing us together, and thank you for all the boys and girls that are watching this program. This is not an ordinary program. This is a program where they learn about God, where they hear about Jesus who loves them. I pray you'll help us to make this lesson clear and make it so that everybody understands exactly what I'm saying. And I thank you for it all in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Now, if you're going to win a quiet seat, and maybe I didn't say this, but you got to sing real loud on all the songs. And speaking of singing loud on all the songs, we're going to go outside right now to old Nicodemus, and he's going to lead you in some singing, so don't you forget to sing loud. If you don't, I just might arrest you.
Howdy, howdy. Oh, we're so glad you're here today. Everybody, stand up with me. Song service time. We got a special treat this morning. I ask old Barkamaeus here, he's going to lead us in his first song. So you be real good and sing with him. Are you ready, Bark?
Yep.
1, 2, 3, hit it!
All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. Throw up your lunch, fall on your nose. The Holy Ghost is gonna wiggle your toes.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Hold it, hold it. That is silly, Barkamaeus.
No.
Ain't the way the song goes.
All right.
I guess I'm just going to have to sing it for you. Let's try it again. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. So throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost's going to shake this place. Throw up your hands. Fall on your face, the Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. So throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. Throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. So throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost gonna shake this place. Throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. So throw up your hands, fall on your face. The Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. Throw up your hands and fall on your face. The Holy Ghost is gonna shake this place. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living, living. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love living bread. All of God's children love that living bread. Ooh, that's good singing. Give yourself a big old hand. And boys and girls, I want you to get ready, because this next song is a contest song. That's right, contest between the boys and the gorillas. Excuse me, I mean the girls. And it's to see who can sing the loudest. I'm going to sing it once through for you. You follow me. It goes like this. The boys sing first like this.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
And then the girls sing.
Praise ye the Lord.
And then the boys sing,
hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
And then the girls sing,
praise ye the Lord.
And the boys sing again,
praise ye the Lord.
Girls,
hallelujah.
Boys,
praise ye the Lord.
Girls,
hallelujah.
Boys,
praise ye.
And then the girls,
hallelujah.
And then everybody sings real loud, praise ye the Lord. Do you think you can handle that? All right, we're going to start it right now. I want the girls to go first. You ready, girls? Girls first. Sing now. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, girls, I can't hear you. Boys, praise ye the Lord. And then the girls, hallelujah. Come on, girls, you can sing louder than that. Boys, praise ye the Lord. And then the girls, praise ye the Lord. Boys, hallelujah. Girls, praise ye the Lord. Boys, hallelujah. Girls, praise ye. And then the boys, hallelujah. And everybody realize, praise ye the Lord. That was pretty close that time. I think the boys won. So let's start it all over and let the boys go first this time. Boys, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. And then the girls, praise ye the Lord. Boys, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come on now, girls, praise ye the Lord. Come on, boys, praise ye the Lord. Girls, boys, praise ye the Lord. Come on, girls, hallelujah. Boys, praise ye. And the girls, hallelujah. Everybody, praise ye the Lord. What do you think, Barkamas? I think you're right. I think the girls did win that time. Girls, give yourself a big hand. It's really good singing. Very, very good singing. Ho, ho, ho. Yeah, help me sing this. Like this. Praise him. You got to praise him. I said praise him in the morning. I praise him in the noontime. Praise him. Praise him. I praise him when the sun goes down. You got to love him. I said love him. Oh, love him in the morning. I love him in the noontime. love him. I said, love him, oh, I love him when the sun goes down. You got to thank him, remember to thank him. Thank him, oh, thank him in the morning. I thank him in the noontime. Thank him, you got to thank him, oh, I thank him when the sun goes down. You got to praise him, remember now, praise him. I praise him in the morning, I praise him in the noontime. Praise him, I said praise him, oh, I praise him when the sun goes down. All right, speed it up a little bit, fellas. Wonderful, wonderful, Jesus is to me. Counselor, Prince of Peace, the mighty God is he. Saving me, keeping me from all sin and shame. Wonderful is my Redeemer, praise his name. Wonderful, wonderful, Jesus is to me. Counselor, Prince of Peace, mighty God is he. Saving me, he's keeping me from all sin and shame. Wonderful is my Redeemer, praise his name. Wonderful, wonderful, Jesus is to me. Let me hear you. Counselor, the Prince of Peace, mighty God is he. Saving me and keeping me from all sin and shame. Wonderful is my Redeemer, praise his name. Wonderful is my Redeemer, praise his name. Let's all just do that. Let's lift our hands and praise the Lord. Oh, Lord, we just praise you and thank you today. Man, that is such good, good, good singing. You can all be seated right now. Boy, they're singing good, aren't they, Barkamas?
Yep, sure.
Boy, you could really hear the girls singing today, Eugene. The girls were singing great. Oh, yes, and I love little girls. I love you, I love you. Now, wait a minute. I didn't bring you out here today for you to flirt with the girls. You don't flirt with the girls who come to watch this program. Now, none of that. Well, let me sing a song for them. No, you're not going to sing a song for them. The girls hate the way you sing. They really don't like the way you sing. You sing terrible, Eugene. You sing rotten, and nobody likes it. Nobody... You like your singing? You got to be kidding. All right, one song, one song, and it better be quick. Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Now, wait a minute. You sang it the other day. You sang the same song the other day. I know, but it's got a different verse. Red and yellow, pink and green, you're the cutest chick I've seen. Now, wait a minute, it's not red and yellow, pink and green. You're the cutest chick I've seen. Now, you just stop that. We have more important things to talk about here on this program. You know, right now we're going to talk about how that Jesus took the keys of death and hell away from the devil. Did you know that when Jesus was raised from the dead, he took Satan's keys away?
Really? Well, speaking of keys, I want to ask you a question.
You have a question to ask me about keys?
That's right. Do you know how many keys Noah took on the ark?
Do I know how many keys that Noah took on the ark?
Mm-hmm.
How many keys did Noah take on the ark? Wait a minute, Eugene. Noah didn't take any keys on the ark. They didn't have keys in Noah's day.
Oh, yes, they did. He took some keys onto the ark.
Noah did not take keys onto the ark.
Oh, yes, he did.
Noah did not take keys on the ark. They didn't have keys. They didn't invent keys till later on. Noah did not take keys on the ark.
Yes, he did.
He took keys on the ark? Noah took keys on the ark?
Oh, yes. He took monkeys and donkeys and turkeys.
Monkeys, donkeys, and turkeys. Ha ha, never mind. Let's do something else. Monkeys, donkeys, and turkeys.
So Abraham, do you see, it's real important that you set a good example, like old Barkamas does, and exercise and try real hard. Right, Barkamas? Where's Barkamas? Barkamas, get over here. What are you doing? It's time for exercising right now. Everybody get up. Come on, Abraham. Everybody get up out there, too. Now, come on now, stand up. It's time for exercising. This is a real important time. So everybody get loosened up, get limbered up. And first off, we're going to do the old climb the ladder exercise. Let me show you how that goes. It goes like this. Like this. Yeah, climb the ladder, reach up there, pull them muscles. Oh, that's good, Barker Man. Abraham, come on in. You can do it, Abraham. I got confidence in you. Stick them and paws way up there in the air. That's right, way up there. Yeah, that's good, that's good. Get, go, 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 go. Stick it way up in the air. Ho, hoo, three, four. Man, that's good. You out there too. Stretch, stretch, three, four. Woo, that's good. Okay, hold it, hold it, hold it. Think we need a little running in place right now, fellas. What do you say? Come on now. Running in place. Hit it. Let's go now. Running in place. Come on now. That's right. Run, run, run. That's good. That's good, Barkman. Hold it, Abraham. Hold it, hold it, hold it. No, no, no. Don't run away. I don't mean to run away. Just run in place, see? Get them legs moving. Fast, 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 fast. Come on, move fast, fast. Get them moving fast, fast. That's right, that's right. That's good. Woo, look at that. Barkman, let's go. Woo. Run, run. Hold it. Hold it, hold it, hold it. This time, we want to go the side-to-side exercise like this. Go like this. See? Right here. Here we go. That's good. Go hit it out there, too. Come on in. Two, three, four, five, two, three. That's good. Yeah, what? Come on, Abraham. Now, this ain't right. You got to be in it. Remember, I talked to you. Remember that talk we had? All right, now let's try. Come on. Side to side. Side to side. Side to side. Come on. Ooh, that's good, Abraham. I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. Keep it going. Keep it going. Move, move, three, four. Ooh, look at that Barker Man. Let's go. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Do a little more hopping. What do you say? Just a little hopping now. One, two, three, go. Hop, 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 hop. Hop, Abraham. Come on, Abraham. Hop, 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 hop. Two, three, four. Hop, two, three, four. Hop, 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 hop. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Praise the Lord, exercise. Three, four, praise the Lord. And practice praising the Lord like this. Three, four, come on, Abraham. You praise the Lord better now. Three, four, praise the Lord. And offering exercise. Come on now, let's practice giving offerings. In the pocket, in the plate, and in the pocket, in the plate. Come on, Abraham, practice giving them offerings. God blesses you when you give them offerings. Oh, hold it, hold it, hold it. That's all, fellas. You can sit down and rest, and you can out there, too. That's real good this morning. I'm real proud of you. Yeah, that's good. That's all right.
Wow. Are you sweating and puffing and panting? Well, man, you ought to be after all that exercise. Boy, I'll tell you what, that's quite a workout. Now, listen, I want to talk to you about something really important, something really special. So I want you to look right here at this jail. You know, every now and then, I have to lock folks up and put them here in the jail. I have to put them inside because they break the law. You know, when they go into this jail, they don't get out. They stay in there until they've paid their dues, until they've finished their sentence. And you know, that's the way it is with a jail. A jail is kind of like death. You see, when you die, you get locked up. You get locked up away from your friends and away from your family. You see, when someone dies, they can't get out. They can't escape death. Nobody can. And until Jesus came, nobody ever came back from death. But you know what? Now that Jesus came and died on the cross and was raised from the dead, He changed all of that. Now when someone dies, they won't always be dead. Now when you die, your spirit can go to live with Jesus, but even your body will come back to life someday. Your body will come back to life someday when Jesus comes. You see, if Jesus doesn't come right away, and if you grow up to be an old man or an old woman and someday you die, you don't have to worry because Jesus is going to come. He has the keys of death and of hell. He's going to come with those keys and unlock the graves of every person who has died, who trusted in Him. And He will open up the grave so that your body can come out and your body will be alive again. That's good news. Jesus has the power to set us free from death. So when you trust in Him, you have life inside. Now, right now, we want to thank Jesus and tell Him just how much we love Him. And there's no better way to do it than to just close your eyes and sing this song with Nicodemus.
Hey, I want everybody to stand up with me. Would y'all stand with me this morning? We're going to take a real special test right now. This test is a little different. You see, it's a spiritual test. I'm not the one that grades this test. The Holy Spirit grades it. And I'm not going to tell you how to pass it. You got to figure it out, okay? Worthy, oh, worthy are you, Lord. I'm looking for kids that are passing. Worthy to be thanked and praised and worshiped and adored. I see a few out there passing. Everybody needs to pass this now. Oh, worthy, yes, worthy are you, Lord. Yeah, there's more passing now. 'Cause you're worthy to be thanked and praised and worshiped and adored. Now, I want you to really sing this with me. It goes like this. Singing. Test. You're worthy to be thanked and praised and worshiped and adored. Worthy, so worthy are you, Lord. Worthy to be thanked and praised and worshiped and adored. Now really sing with me. Worship the King. Singing. Hallelujah. Glory to the King. Worship and adore you to make your glory. Sing it to him one more time. Really sing it. Lift our hands and praise you now and worship your name and give you glory. Everybody lift your hands and praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for all the wonderful things you've done for us. Praise your holy name. Oh, man, that was great singing and great praise. And right now, you can all be seated.
One day, old Johnny came in from playing. His nose was all bloody. His eyes were full of tears. And his mother says, "What's wrong?" He said, "It's that Larry. He beat me up again." "Ooh, that Larry," said Mother, "somebody's going to have to teach him a lesson." But nobody was big enough to teach old Larry a lesson. Larry was the bully of the neighborhood. He was a 12-year-old kid who was extra big for his age, and man, was he a bully. He beat up everybody. When those kids wanted to play baseball, Larry would walk in the game and say, "It's my turn to bat," even when it wasn't his turn to bat. And then he'd pick up the bat, and he'd get 5 strikes and 6 strikes, and all the other kids would holler and yell and saying, "Quit batting, Larry, you've already struck out." But Larry wouldn't leave because he was big enough to do whatever he wanted to do. And then when it was time to play football, whenever Larry got the football, he wouldn't let anybody else have it. He could run all over the field, and nobody could tackle him because he was so big, and he ruined every single game. But then one day, old Johnny decided to build a secret clubhouse. He was going to build it in an old tree down by the creek. So he and some of his friends snuck down there with some boards and some other things and hammer and nails, and they went down there and they started nailing and hammering, and pretty soon they had a neat-looking clubhouse built up in the tree. But they didn't want old Larry to know about it. They were playing up there. After a while, guess who showed up? It was old Larry. He climbed up the ladder into that treehouse and said, "How strong did you make this treehouse?" And he started pushing on this board and pushing on that board and kicking on this one. In just a few minutes, he tore up the whole treehouse, laughing about the whole thing. And then he climbed right down the ladder and walked out of the field and left those guys standing there crying because he tore up their treehouse they'd been working on all day. That Larry was the meanest bully in the whole neighborhood. But nobody could stop him. "Boy," said Johnny, "I wish there was somebody who could stop old Larry. I wish somebody would just teach him a lesson." A couple of weeks passed, and one day, Johnny saw a moving van. Somebody was moving into a house that was 3 doors down the street. Well, Johnny walked down there to see who it was, and boy, was he happy. There was a brand new kid moving into Johnny's neighborhood. Well, Johnny went and knocked on the door, and this big kid comes and stands on the porch, and Johnny says, "Wow, what's your name?" "My name's Tony," said the kid. Well, how old are you, Tony? 13 or 14? Tony says, "Nope, I'm just 12. "You're just 12 years old? Well, wow, you sure are big." Johnny couldn't wait to tell his friends, "Hey, there's this new kid, and he moved in, and he's 3 doors down the street from me, and his name is Tony, and he's real nice, too. And old Tony is even bigger than Larry." Well, the next day, they all decided to play baseball. And old Johnny went first of all down to Tony's house, and he asked old Tony to come with him to play ball. Well, they were out there playing baseball, and old Tony was playing pitcher, and about that time, here comes that big, fat bully, Larry. He walked on and says, "Well, I guess it's my turn to bat." And old Tony put down his baseball glove and he walked over there and he looked right into old Larry's eyes and he says, "It's not your turn to bat, mister. You get in line and you wait your turn." Old Larry was so scared of big old Tony, he was so scared that he ran home and he quit bullying those kids around and they never had trouble with him again. You see, all that needed to happen was for someone bigger than the bully to come to town. And that's what stopped that guy from being such a big bully. You know what Jesus did? Jesus was bigger than the devil. And Jesus stopped the devil from pushing people around. So the next time you think about a bully, you think about how Jesus defeated the biggest bully who ever lived, and that's the devil, because Jesus cares for you.
It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right, Mary. Now calm down. We'll be okay. You see, our brother Lazarus just died, our only brother, and we love him very much. Lazarus, we love you, and we're going to miss you. Oh, I wish it wouldn't have happened, Mary. I wished he were still alive. Oh, why did he have to die? If only Jesus had been here. If Jesus had been here, everything would be fine. Everything would be fine because Jesus could have made our brother well again. Jesus could have healed the sickness that made our brother to die. And I know we'll see our brother again at the last day in the resurrection. But I wish we could see him now. Oh, Lazarus, we love you so much and we miss you. Why couldn't Jesus be here?
to score really big points on the All-American Bible Quiz game. Do you realize that each correct answer in this edition of our game is going to score you 5,000 points? Now, girls, you're going to get a chance to score five different times. That means that during this session alone, you'll be able to score up to 25,000 points. So I hope you've been listening to all the different things that have been said, because we're pulling the questions from material we've just covered here on the Vacation Bible School. Now, here comes your first question, girls. I hope you were listening. What were the names of Lazarus' two sisters? He had two sisters. What were their names? If you know the answer to that question, you can score up to 5,000 points for your team. Now, here's what you got to do. Raise your hand up high, and the teacher should call on five girls and get them up right now, teacher, and let those girls take turns whispering in your ear. Only five girls per turn. What were the names of Lazarus' sisters? And as those girls come up, teachers, give them 5,000 points for each correct answer that they get, okay? And if you answer that question correctly, all five of you girls, that means you're going to score up to 25,000 points, and that's a lot of points. Now, boys, in just a minute, your turn's coming up, and you're going to be able to score some big points, too. You're going to be able to score 5,000 points each, so I hope you pay attention, especially during the next few minutes, because you'll be able to score 5,000 points, 25,000 points total on the All-American Bible Quiz game. So once again, girls, here's your question as you answer in the teacher's ear. What were the names of Lazarus' two sisters? And boys, we'll give you another chance in just a few minutes to score points on the All-American Bible Quiz game.
Let's take a look at one of the largest members of the reptile family, the alligator. The American alligator is found in the swampy coastal areas of the United States, from eastern Texas all the way to Florida. He grows to be 500 pounds and can live as long as 30 years. Although alligators and crocodiles are much alike, there is a difference. The alligator has a wide snout, while his crocodile cousin has a long, narrow snout. Alligators are very dangerous creatures, and they must be treated with extra caution. They have many sharp teeth in a mouth with powerful jaws. If an alligator's mouth is open, his powerful jaws can crush almost anything in their bite. But if the gator's mouth is closed, you can hold it together with your hand. You see, all of his strength is set to close and not to open his mouth. Alligators eat ducks, muskrats, deer, and even cattle. A grown alligator can knock a man to the ground with one swing from his powerful tail. And that's why they're so dangerous. Once an alligator bites his prey, he goes quickly under the water to drown it. He can stay underwater from 2 to 5 hours. Wow, that's a long time to hold your breath. The Bible tells us that the devil is like a dragon. And in Bible days, dragons were really crocodiles and alligators. When Jesus was raised from the dead, he gave us victory over that old dragon, the devil. We who have Jesus inside us have power over the devil and over all his works of death and destruction. So, when I see an alligator, it reminds me of the authority that Jesus gave me over the devil and all his works. So long, Mr. Alligator. See you later.
The people gathered around and they screamed at the top of their voices, "Crucify him! Nail him to the cross!" And they did just that. An angry mob had Jesus nailed to a cross. They put his body on an old splintery board and nailed it through the hands and through his feet, raised him up, and after Jesus hung there on that cross for a few hours, he died. Then they took his body, his friends took his body, and they wrapped his body up very carefully in grave clothes, and they went and put his body inside a grave, and then they rolled a stone over the door. You see, the chief priests and scribes, the ones who didn't want to see Jesus live, the ones who wanted Jesus to be crucified, they went to the Roman soldiers and they said, make sure that you put some stone over that door so that Jesus' disciples don't come and steal his body away. And then they'll go tell everybody he was raised from the dead. Well, they rolled that stone over the door. And the Roman soldiers stood there and they guarded the door of Jesus' grave and they said nobody can get in. So after Jesus' friends wrapped up the body in grave clothes, they couldn't get back into the body. Well, day one passed and the body of Jesus lay in the grave. Nothing happened. Day two passed, and the body of Jesus lay in the grave. Nothing happened. Day three passed, but on the morning of that third day, very early in the morning, something happened. All of a sudden, the earth began to shake. The soldiers who were standing outside began to tremble. There was an earthquake. Rocks began to fall off the hillside. Trees began to rattle. Their leaves were shaking. And all of a sudden, that big stone that was covering the door of Jesus' grave rolled out of the way. It took 12 men to put that thing in place. And one angel took his hand and moved it out of the way from the inside of that grave. And he stood and looked at those soldiers and he said, "Jesus Christ is risen from the dead." Those soldiers got so scared they fell down and fainted. Then they upped and ran away. Do you know what happened? The greatest thing in all the history of mankind happened. Jesus Christ was raised from the dead. Do you know what happened when Jesus was raised from the dead? Jesus took away the sting of death. You see, every person will die. Every person has to die. And because of death, there's things that hurt us. Death hurts people. It's not good. God didn't make death. Death came because of sin. But when Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, it gives us the assurance that someday we'll receive a brand new body that will never, ever die. You see, Jesus wants us to live forever. Jesus overcame death. He took the sting right out of death. So, we don't have to be afraid of death, because when death came against Jesus, Jesus overcame death. Jesus took the sting right out of death. And you know what? For the last 2,000 years, the devil has been scared. He's been frightened, because when Jesus was raised from the dead, it knocked the devil's teeth out. I want you to know that old Satan's teeth are knocked out. I mean, he's still chattering. He's still afraid. His teeth are still chattering because Jesus Christ popped him in the mouth when he was raised from the dead. So the greatest thing that ever happened, happened when Jesus was raised from the dead, and the devil is still afraid of that.
I hear the Holy Ghost talking, he's lifted up Jesus. Yeah. The Holy Ghost talking, he's lifted up Jesus. Yeah, I hear the Holy Ghost talking, he's lifted up Jesus, and he's lifting me too. Yeah, he's lifting me too, y'all. I hear the Holy Ghost talking, and he's lifting up Jesus. I hear the Holy Ghost talking, he's lifting up Jesus. Ooh, yeah, I hear the Holy Ghost talking, and he's lifting up Jesus. And he's lifting me too. He's lifting me too, yeah. The Holy Ghost talking, he's lifting up Jesus. I hear the Holy Ghost talking, and he's lifting up Jesus. And he's lifting me too. All right, yeah. He's lifting me too, yeah. Oh, look out now. Woo! I hear the Holy Ghost talking, he's lifting up Jesus. The Holy Ghost talking, he's lifting up Jesus. I hear the Holy Ghost talking, he's lifting up Jesus. And he's lifting me too, yeah. Woo! He's lifting me too, y'all. All right.
And And now it's time to play another exciting round of the All-American Bible Quiz Game. Now listen, fellas, it's your turn to answer questions. And if you get these answers right, you're going to score 5,000 points each. That means you five boys who are going to answer during this session are going to be able to score 25,000 points. I hope you've been paying attention, because listening and paying close attention gives you the ability to know the answer. Now, here comes the question. And remember, if you know the answer, don't say it out loud. Raise your hand. The teacher will call on you, all right? The teacher will call on you, and he'll ask you or she'll ask you to come to the front of the room, and you can whisper the answer correctly in the teacher's ear. And when you do, you're going to score 5,000 points. So here comes the question. What one thing that Jesus did paralyzed the devil? What one thing that Jesus did paralyzed the devil? Now, if you know what one thing that Jesus did was that paralyzed the devil, you raise your hand up, and as you are called on, the teacher will ask you to come up front, begin to whisper that answer in the teacher's ear. Now, teacher, right now is the time to do it. Do it quickly. And remember, you give those boys 5,000 points for each correct answer that they give you. 5,000 points each. Here's the question again. What one thing that Jesus did paralyzed the devil? And if you get that answer right, you're going to score 5,000 points. Now, girls, oh, listen, we're coming down to the end of the week. I mean, we don't have much time left. You better listen and get every one of these next questions right, because they're important. You'll score big points on the All-American Bible Quiz Game.
Hurry up. This is the day we're going to do it before Gospelville gets here. Think.
This chair ain't working today.
All right. Well, let's try this one over here,
okay.
All right?
Okay.
All right. I'll look out the window.
Okay, you watch for him.
All right, I'll do it.
I got it.
He's not coming
in.
Oh, what is it?
This is great.
All right,
we'll have a body rolling contest.
A body rolling contest?
Yeah, a body rolling contest.
What's
I'll show
that?
You what we'll do.
All right.
First, I need to clear the desk off. Move all this stuff out of the way. And see, we'll roll bodies, see?
Roll bodies?
Yeah. Yeah. And see, it's... Oh, wait, they're here. Hi.
Oh,
it's good to see you today. Oh, we got a great one for you today. Okay. We got to be quick before Gospel Bill gets here, though.
Yeah, hurry up.
We're going to play body rolling, okay?
Yeah. He thought of it.
I just thought of it. Hey, what we need to do is get kids paired up in two, see?
And probably
you want to get a littler kid to roll and a bigger kid to roll him. And see, you do like this. You get the kid and you lay him down like this. And you start at one end of the classroom, see? And you start rolling. And the one that gets to the other end of the classroom is the winner of the body rolling contest. The one that gets there first. Don't that sound great?
That's a good idea.
So
hurry up,
we need you to pair off and...
Pair off? What are you talking about today, fellas?
We're too late again.
What kind of a contest do you have going now?
Well, we did have a body rolling contest.
Just a little body rolling.
A body rolling contest.
It was great.
It was gentle to Gospel Bill. Just rolling bodies down to see who can get from one end of the classroom to the other.
Rolling bodies?
Yeah, kids rolling kids.
You want to see?
See, watch this.
Yeah.
See, you get them down, and you get it one end, and you go, go! And then you roll them real fast as you can, see?
Wait a minute. That'll never work.
You don't think so?
No, there's not enough room in the class to do that. And besides all that, the kids will mess their clothes up, and their hair will get all messed up, and they'll get dirty, and there's all the chairs to move. Besides, we don't need to have a contest like that.
Why not?
Well, we're going to have a break. We're going to take an offering and have some refreshments, go to the restroom, get a drink. All of that stuff's coming up now.
Okay.
And you're talking about a body rolling contest.
Well, we'll get a good one for tomorrow.
I'll tell you what, we can't get a good one for tomorrow.
There isn't going to be a tomorrow. This is the last day, Barker Man.
We got a whole year. Come on, I want to tell you about some of my ideas
for
next year.
A whole year? Your ideas are terrible. Well, howdy. Hey, it's good to see you, and welcome back to the second half of Vacation Bible School. Now listen, I want you to get your pencil and your paper out, or your crayon, or whatever you're going to write with, because this is your last chance to find these hidden letters. Now, today's word has five letters in it, and those letters are going to appear from time to time throughout Dry Gulch here as you watch during the next few minutes. So you get ready to watch and look and see if you can find letters like this one, the letter L. Now, this is the first letter for today, and we always give you one so you'll know what they look like. They're blue on a white background, so you keep your eyes peeled because you never know when one of these letters is going to pop up. And then, at the end of the program, if you think you can unscramble these letters and find a hidden word, if you're one of the first five kids who whispers this to the teacher's ear, you may win a prize. So don't you blow your chances by looking off somewhere or by bothering that kid next to you. Hello, Bartimaeus.
Oh, hello, Gospelbill.
Well, you look down in the dumps. What's wrong with you? Come here.
Have you heard, Gospelbill? Have you heard?
Have I heard what?
About Nicodemus.
About Nicodemus? What happened to Nicodemus?
Oh, nothing happened to Nicodemus, but his grandfather passed away.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
And he's coming right here, right now.
Now, wait a minute. Nicodemus is coming right here, right now? His grandfather passed away?
And we need to be really nice to him, Gospelbill.
Oh, I will. Don't worry about it. Come on in, Nicodemus. Come on in. Sit down over here.
Hello, Nicodemus.
Sit down right here. I'm sorry to hear about your grandfather, Nicodemus.
Yeah. Just got one question, Gospel Bill. How come it is people gotta die anyhow?
Well, I want to tell you, it's not God's fault that people die. In fact, there wasn't any death at all till Adam sinned in the Garden of Eden. You see, when God first made the earth, Nicodemus, nobody was ever going to die. But when man sinned against God, it opened up the door for death to come in the world. But I want you to listen. I got some good news for you.
Why did it have to happen? Why did it have to happen? My grandfather just passed away, and I won't ever get to see him again. He was my favorite grandpa, and he used to take me fishing and to the park and swimming and all that stuff. He was so good to me, and now he's gone, and I won't ever get to see him again.
Now, wait a minute, Eugene. Don't cry so much.
But, Jeannie Mae, I can't help it. I miss Grandpa.
I know, and so do I. But don't be so sad.
Oh, Jeannie, I can't help but be sad. It's terrible. I'll never get to see my favorite Grandpa again.
Now, that's not true. You will get to see him again.
I'll get to see him again? But when?
In heaven. Don't you know that Grandpa was a Christian?
Well, yes, he was a great guy. I know he was a Christian.
Well, then you'll see him again.
Well, how will I see him again, Jeannie? How will I see him?
You'll see him when we go to heaven. Eugene, when someone dies, that's not the end.
What do you mean?
Well, Grandpa still lives.
He's still alive?
Yes, but his body is dead. But the real Grandpa, his spirit, is still alive. And one day when Jesus returns, we'll go to see Grandpa. And he'll be alive again, and he'll even have his old body back again. Except this time it'll be young and new.
Well, you mean Jesus is going to raise Grandpa up from the dead?
That's right. We'll all be raised from the dead. So don't worry, Eugene. You'll get to see him again soon.
Oh, boy, Jeannie, I sure am glad you told me that. I love Grandpa so much, I just hate to think of never seeing him again forever. That would be terrible.
Well, you'll see him again.
Oh, boy, thanks a lot, Jeannie. Thanks for telling me that.
Well, I'm sure glad you told me that, Gospel Bill. I'm going to get to see my Grandpa again.
You sure will.
Yep. Hey, Gospel Bill. Is that really true? Will his grandfather really come back to life?
Yes, sir. His grandfather will come back to life. You see, when a Christian dies, Bartimaeus, that's not all there is to it. His spirit goes to heaven to be with Jesus. But one day when Jesus comes back, he's going to give us a brand new body. He'll give us a brand new body that will never, ever die. So Christians are going to live forever.
Boy, that's great.
Gospel Bill, come quick.
What is it, Nicodemus?
Come quick.
What is it?
Charlie McIntosh just got run over by a stagecoach in front of the general.
Come on, Bartimaeus, let's go.
Looks like he's dead.
Charlie McIntosh. All right, folks, thanks a lot for helping. Now, y'all go on home now. We'll take care of this. Nicodemus, you get to the old doc right away. Tell him to get down here. Okay. We're going to need his help.
What happened?
I'm sorry, Miss McIntosh. He got run over by a stagecoach.
Oh, no. He's bleeding.
Now he's going to be all right. Now, don't worry about it. Now, listen. Try to control yourself. Try to calm down. It's not going to be as bad as it looks.
Doc's out of town. Don't look like he'll be back till night.
Oh, Charlie.
What are we going to do?
Lay your hands on him, Nick. We're going to pray.
Okay.
Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for Charlie's life. It won't be good if Charlie dies now. He's too young. Lord, in Jesus' name, we pray that the spirit of life in Christ Jesus would enter into his body now, and we drive away death in the name of Jesus. Spirit of death, I rebuke you. And Father God, I thank you for life that goes into Charlie and healing. Heal his body, Father. Jesus took his infirmities and bore his sicknesses. Thank you, Lord, for healing Charlie and making him to live. He'll live and not die. He'll live and not die. He'll live and not die.
Boy, Eugene, I'll bet you're really sad. I know I was when my grandfather died.
Yeah, sort of. But I'm getting over it, because after all, I am going to see him again.
I thought you said he died.
Oh, he did.
But you said you were going to see him again.
That's right. I am going to see him again.
But how can that be?
You see, my grandfather was a believer, a Christian. He had Jesus in his heart.
Well,
that means that when a Christian dies, he doesn't die for good. You see, my grandfather's going to be raised from the dead.
Raised from the dead? But that's impossible.
No, it's not impossible, because Jesus was raised from the dead. All believers are going to be raised from the dead. And I'm going to see my grandfather. You see, when you die, that's not all of it. Your spirit still lives on, Freddie. It still lives on. And now my grandfather is up there with Jesus, and I'm going to get to see him again. That's not all of it. I'll get to see my grandpa again.
Wow, I never heard that before.
Now try to be calm, Miss McIntosh. Now listen, he's going to live. He's going to live. I know he's going to live.
Oh, thank God.
I've got a pulse.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, I've got a pulse. He's going
to
be all right.
The doc just got back into town, and he wants us to try to get him up to the office.
All right, let's be real careful, fellas.
Be easy.
Real careful. Stick your hands under him. He's going to be just fine now, Miss McIntosh. Don't worry about him at all. Just fine. Just fine. Now back him real careful. Real slow, boys. Real slow. Hello there, Ms. Lana.
Hi, Gospel Bill. Is he going to be all right? Is he going to be all right?
Well, of course he's going to be all right. Well, you ought to know the most powerful force in all the universe is the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. Charlie will live and not die.
Ms. Lana, guess what? Charlie McIntosh already come too. And Doc got into town and said it looks like he's going to be fine.
I told you he's going to be
God.
That way.
Hallelujah.
I want to introduce you to a special friend of mine. Her name is Geraldine, and she is an ostrich. Come here, Geraldine. Geraldine, I want to talk to you. Well, as you can see, ostriches are very large. In fact, they're the largest birds on Earth. A full-grown ostrich stands 8 feet tall.
Wow!
That's as tall as the average ceiling. Can you imagine a bird as tall as the ceiling in your living room? These ostriches weigh up to 300 pounds, so don't ever try to cook one. They're much too big for your oven. Ostriches can run up to 60 miles per hour. They have powerful legs, but their wings are very, very small. And of course, ostriches cannot fly. How would you like to have an ostrich nesting in a tree outside your house? That would be terrible. Imagine getting hit in the head with an ostrich egg. You'd be cuckoo. Now this is Fran. She's not an ostrich at all. What is she doing in this picture? She is an emu. That's the ostrich's Australian cousin. These ostriches live in Africa. There they live in great numbers and live often to be 70 years of age. That's a long time. Come here, Geraldine. There you go. Ow, Geraldine, don't try to bite me. Ow, don't do that. I want to pet you. I don't want you to bite me. Baby ostriches hatch out to be 1 foot tall, and they grow very quickly. In only 30 days, a baby ostrich can run up to 35 miles per hour. That's faster than the fastest man on Earth. Ostriches have few natural enemies, and they live a long time. In fact, we can learn a lesson from them. The Word of God says that if we honor our fathers and mother, we'll live a long time on the earth.
Hey, girls, this is your last chance to score big points on the All-American Bible Quiz game, and I hope you've been listening.
Because, oh man, you don't have any other chances. You've got to get all these answers right. And don't say the answer out loud. Just raise your hand if you think you know what the answer is. And the teacher will call on five girls. And you five girls will come to the front of the class and whisper that answer in the teacher's ear. And remember now, each correct answer is going to give the girls' team 5,000 points. So if all five of you girls get your answers right, that's 25,000 points to add on to your total. And you need every one of them. So I hope you've been paying attention to all the things we've just talked about. All right, here comes your question, girls. Why was Eugene upset? He was upset. I want you to raise your hand if you know why he was upset. He was really sad and crying. Why was he crying? Why was he upset? If you know the answer to that question, raise up your hand right now, and you'll be able to score big points on the All-American Bible Quiz game. Now remember, girls, raise your hand. Don't say the answer out loud. And teacher, get those girls up there right now and get their answers. And be sure to give them 5,000 points for each answer that they get correct. All right. Now, fellas, in just a minute, you're going to get your last chance to score points. So I hope you're paying close attention to the next few things that are said. In fact, if you're not listening, you may miss the answer. So you pay very close attention. In just a minute, you're going to be able to score up to 25,000 points on the All-American Bible Quiz game. Girls, one more time, here's your question. Why was Eugene upset? Answer that question correctly, and you're able to score big points on the All-American Bible Quiz game.
We're so glad to have you back, Lazarus. We're so glad.
Hey, I'm glad to be back. Boy, wasn't that some miracle?
Yes, it was a miracle. Have you ever heard of that before?
Well, I knew Jesus raised people from the dead, but not anyone who'd been dead for 4 days already.
Oh, I didn't think we'd see you for a long, long time. Not until heaven. But now we're going to see you every day.
Yeah, I'm glad to be back, sisters. I really am. Boy, I'll tell you, that paradise is a neat place. I saw Moses, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, all of those guys. I even saw David.
You did? You saw all those guys?
Sure. Lots of folks think when you die, you die. That's it. But I'll tell you, your spirit keeps on living. And I was there in paradise, but I heard Jesus calling my name.
What did it sound like?
It sounded like an earthquake when he spoke. I mean, when Jesus talks, everybody listens.
Wow, that was neat. He stood right there at the door of your grave, and he said, Lazarus, come forth.
Yeah, and I heard him all the way to paradise. And my spirit, it was drawn right back here, just like a magnet. Just exactly like a magnet. And I knew I had to come back.
Well, we're glad to have you back.
Boy, could you fix me something to eat? I'm getting kind of hungry. I haven't had anything in 4 days.
Sure we can. Can't we, Mary? Come on, we'll fix you something to eat.
What we're going to do right now is probably the most important thing that's been done all week long. And right now, I want you to sit up straight and pay close attention. And right now, I want the ushers and the teachers to pass out all of the elements of communion, because in just a minute, we're going to observe the Lord's Supper. You know, Jesus loves you with all of His heart. He cares so much for you, you'll never really fully know all the love that He has for you, because Jesus gave Himself as a sacrifice for your sin. You see, we all have sin. I have it, you have it, your mom and dad have it. We all have it. The only way we can ever get rid of it is to trust in Jesus, because Jesus did something very important for us. You see, Jesus was punished for our sin. He was punished for the things that we did wrong, and He was punished for the iniquity that was in our hearts. You see, Jesus let, first of all, men break His body. They broke His body, and when I say they broke His body, I mean they really broke it. They took a whip, a Roman scourge, and they beat Jesus' body. They stripped His back of its clothes, and they beat His back again and again till the skin was almost completely removed. Jesus' back was beaten and bloodied so that our healing could be paid for. And that's just how much Jesus loves you. He loves you with all of His heart. The Bible tells us that His body was broken so that our healing could be paid for. But that's not all that Jesus did, because shortly after He took the beating, He was taken out to a hill called Calvary, or Golgotha in the Hebrew tongue. And Jesus was there crucified. They nailed Him on a cross. They spit on Him, they pulled the whiskers out of His face, and then they did the most awful thing of all. They took Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, nailed Him to a cross. They took big nails, like the nails I have here, and they took a hammer, and they hit Jesus again and again, again and again. They hit Him and hit Him until the nails went all the way through His hands and then His feet, And then they lifted up Jesus on that cross. And boys and girls, the precious blood of the Son of God, blood that knew no sin, blood that had never had the trace of wickedness in it, blood that Jesus had from God, it was shed and poured out on the ground for our sin. And when we trust in the blood, when we trust in the blood that Jesus shed for us, we can be forgiven and cleansed of all our sin. One of the most important things we can do is to remember all that Jesus did for us. And one way that we remember is by taking communion. You see, when we eat the bread, and you may not have a loaf of bread that I have, but you have a little piece of something by now, and if you don't, well, they'll pass it to you in just a minute. As you take this and put it in your mouth, it reminds us of the body of Jesus that was broken apart. You see, His body was broken, like this bread is broken. He let those men break His body and make it weak. And His body was broken for us. And so when we eat the bread, we're remembering what Jesus did for us. And then Jesus poured out His precious blood. And when we drink this juice, we're reminded that Jesus' blood was shed for our sin. Now, I want you to listen. I don't want you to move. I don't want you to make a sound. I want you to be still and pay attention to what the Word of God says here in 1 Corinthians. This is what the Apostle Paul said. For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke the bread and said, Take, eat, this is My body which is broken for you. This do in remembrance of Me. Now right now, I want you to take a little piece of that bread. Get the bread in your hand right now. I want you to take a piece of that bread right now, and we're going to put it into our mouths. Now you go ahead and eat it up now, and let's pray. Father, we thank You for the broken body of Jesus, that it was broken so that all our healing could be paid for. Thank You for that broken body, and we'll receive what Jesus did for us. In His name we pray. Amen. Now listen to this. The Bible says, And in the same way also He took the cup, and when He had drank it, He said, This cup is the New Testament in My blood. This do, and as oft as you drink it, do it in remembrance of Me. Now listen to this. For as often as you eat it, as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death until He come. So now I want you to take the grape juice. And you may have a little glass there. I want you to take and just drink it up now. And as you do, we're remembering the blood that Jesus shed. That stands for the blood that Jesus shed on the cross. Let's bow our heads right now. Father, thank You for the blood that Jesus poured out. Thank You that His blood washes away every sin stain and it makes us white again. It makes us clean and free from sin. And Lord, I do thank You that boys and girls who are listening now realize and recognize the importance of what Jesus did for them. Thank You for the bread, the body that was broken so that we could be healed. Thank You for the juice, the blood of Jesus that washes away our sin. And we thank You for speaking to the hearts of boys and girls right now in Jesus' name. Now, I want to talk to you about something else. Perhaps you're sitting here today and you've never let Jesus come to live in your heart. If you've never asked Him to come and live in your heart, you need to. Right now, I want every head bowed and every eye closed. Nobody is to be looking around. I want every head bowed and every eye closed. Nobody is to be looking around. Now, if you're here today and you say, Gospel Bill, I don't have Jesus in my heart. I've never asked Him to come and live in my heart. But I know I need to because He shed His blood for me. His body was broken for me. And I want to ask Jesus Christ, the Son of God, to come into my heart. If you've never done that, I want you to raise your hand up right now. Now, you hold it up high and don't put it down. Hold it up so the teacher can see it. That's right. You hold that hand up right there, right now. Now, the teacher ought to be standing and looking all over this room for some boy or girl who's raising a hand. And you're raising your hand now because you've never let Jesus come to live in your heart. Now, I want all those kids who have their hands raised to stand up by your chair. That's right. I want you to stand up right there by your chair. Get up right there. Stand up right there by your chair. That's right. Okay? Now, I want all the kids who are standing to get out of your seat. I want you to come and stand right up here. If you raised your hand and if you stood up, I want you to get out of your seat and come right up here and stand by this screen because I want you to let Jesus come to live in your heart. I want you to come up here and the teacher's going to meet with you and pray with you as you stand right up here by me, and the teacher will take you to a special room and pray with you and show you how to let Jesus come to live in your heart. So you get up and come on. you haven't asked him to come in your heart already, you get up and come now, because Jesus loves you with all of his heart.
You know, God has blessed us so much. It's so important to tell him thank you for all the good things he's done for us. He never does anything bad. He only does good things for us. So we want to sing right now a real special thank you song to the Lord. So I want everybody to stand up in the class with me. That's right, everybody stand up and help me sing this song. We worship and adore thee, bowing down before thee. Sing it with me. Songs of praise we're singing, a hallelujah's ringing, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Sing this to the Lord, bowing down before thee with songs of praise we're singing. And adore you, Lord. Yes, we do. We're bowing down before thee, because we love you, Lord. Songs of praise we're singing. Our hallelujah's ringing. Now really sing it to him. With your eyes closed and your hands lifted, say, Jesus, I love you and I give you praise for all the good things you've done. Oh, hallelujah. That's great. Everybody sit down right now.
Now it's your last chance, fellas, to score big points on the All-American Bible Quiz Game. And I hope you were listening closely, because if you were, you'll know the answer to this question. Now, listen carefully, guys. At the end of this session, we're going to add up all the points, and we're going to see who won between your team and the girls' team. So, oh, I hope you've been listening, and I hope you get all these answers right. Now, each correct answer scores 5,000 points. Five boys have a chance to answer this question. That means that up to 25,000 points can be scored in this turn. So here comes your question, fellas. Hope you were paying attention. How many times did Lazarus die? How many times did Lazarus die? Don't say the answer out loud or whisper it to anybody else. You raise your hand if you think you know the answer. Teacher, you call on five different boys right now. Get them up there to the front of the class and let them begin to answer that question correctly. Now remember, fellas, each correct answer gives your team 5,000 points. And as soon as this is over with, we're going to add up all the points. You're going to add up all the points and determine who the winner is in the All-American Bible Quiz game. Will the boys win? Will the girls win? Who knows, fellas? You better answer those questions correctly. Now, right now, teacher, you ought to have those fellas up there and get them all wrapped up in answering their questions. And we're asking the question, how many times did Lazarus die? And each correct answer is worth 5,000 points. Oh, I hope you've had fun playing this game this week. And I hope you learn more about the Word of God because it's the most important thing in all your life. And we'll see you later on the All-American Bible Quiz game.
Why are you crying, Barkamaeus?
Oh, Nicodemus, this is the last day of VBS, and I won't see any of those boys and girls anymore.
Oh, that is sad. We'll never see them again. That's terrible. We won't get to see them anymore.
Barkamaeus, what's wrong?
It's the last day, Gospel Bill. We won't get to see us kids anymore.
The VBS is over.
Listen here. You guys quit crying. Hey, quit crying. Now listen. We don't need to cry.
We don't?
No, we need to rejoice.
Wow.
Well, think of all the things these kids have learned this week. Yeah, you have to look on the bright side. We found out that Jesus can give us a brand new heart and take the stony heart away.
Yeah.
We found out that Jesus wants you to be healed. In fact, there were kids watching this week who got healed. Jesus made them well.
Praise God for that.
Yeah, that's something to be happy over. And then we learn how that Jesus is the resurrection and the life, how he raises us from the dead, and how that he's coming again someday. We don't have to be sad.
That was good.
That was real good. Yeah. Remember the first day we talked about the maniac of Gadara and how he was bound by the devil? Yeah. And we talked about how Jesus can set you free from Satan's yoke?
Yeah.
All kinds of things like that we learned.
All right, let's quit crying.
You guys need to dry it up. That's right. Yeah. Wait a minute!
What is it?
You're not going to blow your nose on these.
Why not?
These are not handkerchiefs. Open that up right there and take a look at it, would you? That is not a handkerchief.
Oh.
Those are the t-shirts we're giving away to the kids in each church who bring the most visitors.
Yeah. Ooh,
you guys are going to blow your nose on their t-shirts. Now listen here.
Sorry.
If you want to win a t-shirt, just be the kid in the church who brings the most visitors. And we'll send a t-shirt like this one right to your church, and you can wear it around and show everybody that you won a t-shirt by bringing more visitors than anyone else in your church. Mm-hmm. And then we also have some bicycles here. We're going to be giving them away. Bicycles will be given away to the kid who brings the most visitors across our whole network. Now, teachers, you explain the rules thoroughly to these boys and girls so that they understand. We're going to be giving these bicycles away, one to the boy and one to the girl, who bring the most visitors from across the whole network. And that's going to be exciting. We'll send it to you if you're the one who brings the most. Now, teachers, you be sure to help these kids register all those visitors, make sure they follow the rules, and we have to have your report into our office no later than August 31st, 1985.
Yeah, so, and Gospel Bill, when all this is over, we'll tell you about our ideas for more contests next year that me and Barkamaeus got, okay?
Yeah, they're going to be great.
Oh, they're going to be great.
I hope I don't get any of their ideas. Well, listen, we want to tell you we've really had a good time. We love you. We'll see you later. God bless you. So long.